96, good command. Like I said before the game, it really didn't matter if it was 91 or 99. We know he was going to compete, but that was good. Good fastballs inside of the plate, elevated fastballs. The off-speed pitches were great, so that was a good performance.
Ken?
Alex, given what JD gave your team this year for him to strike the first blow in the first inning there, what that meant?
Yeah, we were talking in the dugout a lot different than last year, the way the series started with the Astros. Benny did a good job going the other way, put impression on them right away. Pierce, that's why he was sitting third today. We felt that there was going to be traffic for JD and for Xander, because of who we had in the first three spots. And he got a good pitch to hit down in the zone. As you know, Hap lives upstairs in the edges of the strike zone. He was disciplined enough to get him down and put a good swing on it.
Brian?
Alex, you saw in Houston last year with starters coming out of the bullpen in October how effectively that worked. Does that give you more confidence this year in doing that? And do you think that's something you might want to use as an option going forward here?
One thing I learned last year, to win a World Series is going to take 25, 27 guys to do it, regardless of their roles. In a perfect world, the starter goes six, you got the seventh inning guy, eighth inning guy, ninth inning, and you move on. But to get 27 outs at this stage right now is very difficult, and sometimes you have to go to plan B or plan C.
Chad? Like, so on Purcell, how far down in that plan A, plan B, plan C was that to use him there? And then what does that change for you going forward?
We'll talk about it tomorrow. I might say C and a half, probably.